Nutrition is an important component of fetal development. Nutritional counseling is necessary for all women during pregnancy. Nutritional status of woman is not only affects her health but also the health of her growing baby. If you still have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon to get latest updates from Nutralife. Hello friends, welcome to Nutralife. I am Dr. Seema. I make videos related to food and nutrition. Today I am going to talk about nutrition management during pregnancy, pregnancy related health problems and their dietary solutions. Pregnancy is the wonderful phase of woman's life. Right from the conception to the delivery, she has to face tremendous changes in her body. Body goes through lots of physical and hormonal changes. A healthy, well-nourished woman whose nutritional status was good prior to becoming pregnant will have very good chance of delivering a healthy full-term baby with normal birth weight. Adequate food intake during pregnancy is important, but entering pregnancy with nutrient reserves have many advantages. This provides safety during the early stages of pregnancy when many women suffering from the morning sickness. A well-nourished body usually have surplus of nutrients. This surplus can be crucial in the first trimester of pregnancy when the ability to eat is impaired due to the hormonal changes. This is the period when adequate nutrition is believed to help protect against birth defects. Because diet affects the course and outcome of pregnancy greatly. The women who are planning becoming pregnant in the near or future distance must learn to follow the principles of good nutrition. All the nutrients for the developing fetus must be supplied by mother's diet or her body's reserves. During pregnancy, additional nutrients and energy is required for development of mother's tissues and blood. Pregnant woman should eat wide variety of food to fulfill her own nutritional requirement as well as the nutritional requirement of her growing fetus. She should consume diet providing additional 350 kilocalories of energy to her daily requirement of energy. Diet should be planned like 60% of the total energy required should be fulfilled from rice, wheat and millets. She can continue her regular dietary pattern with slight modification like increasing quantity of different foods and frequencies of eating food. Infants born to mothers with adequate protein intake are taller, have better brain development and have better ability to fight against diseases. It's very important to consume extra amount of protein during pregnancy. Pregnant woman should consume 30 gram extra protein than her daily requirement. If pregnant woman not consuming adequate amount of protein, she can suffer from pregnancy-induced hypertension. To get good quality proteins, eggs, meat, fish, milk, and poultry should be included in the diet. For vegetarian people, a proper combination of cereals, pulses, nuts will also provide adequate amount of proteins. Adequate amount of cooking oils and fats should be included in the diet. Some micronutrients are specially required in extra amount during pregnancy like folic acid, iron, vitamin C. Regular intake of folic acid throughout the pregnancy reduces the risk of congenital malformation. It also helps to increase the birth weight of baby. Pregnant woman as well as the growing fetus needs iron to meet the high demands of red blood cell formation. Calcium is essential for proper formation of bones and teeth of offspring and to prevent the osteoporosis in mother. Iodine intake ensures proper mental health of the growing fetus. Pregnant woman should include fiber-rich foods in her diet like cereals, pulses and vegetables. She should take plenty of fluids including 8 to 12 glasses of drinking water per day. Salt intake should not be restricted even
the pregnant woman is suffering from pregnancy-induced hypertension and preeclampsia. Adequate intake of nutritious diet will reflect in the required weight gain during pregnancy, around 10 kg of total weight gain. Excess intake of caffeinated drinks, tea, should be avoided as it can affect the fetal growth. Eating fish during pregnancy is always a topic of contradiction. Omega-3 fatty acids from fish are important for fetal brain development, vision, and cardiovascular health. But higher levels of mercury have been deficits in memory, learning ability. Pregnant women should consume those fish that are low in mercury and high in omega-3 fatty acids, like salmon and sardines. She should avoid high mercury fish such as shark, saltfish, tilefish, and king mackerel.
In addition to satisfying these dietary rules, a pregnant woman should undergo regular health checkups for
weight gain, blood pressure, anemia. Should receive tetanus toxoid injection compulsory. It is very important to take 2 to 3 hours rest during daytime and adequate physical exercise. Pregnant woman should not take any drug or medicine without medical advice. Some medicines could be dangerous for fetus. Smoking, tobacco, and alcohol consumption should be avoided.
Many of the health problems that occurs during pregnancy, like nausea, constipation, heartburn, muscle cramps, anemia, pica, can be reduced or prevented by nutritional adjustments. Nausea is a very common issue in pregnancy, which is also known as morning sickness. It can affect the pregnant woman at any time of day or night.
To overcome nausea, pregnant woman should eat dry toast or crackers just after wake up. Drinks fluid between meals, avoid eating high fat and oily food, and consume skimmed milk.
An increase in the progesterone hormone during pregnancy causes the relaxation of body's muscle, including intestine, and it may cause constipation. As pregnancy progresses, the pressure of growing uterus on the rectum may also cause constipation. Iron supplementation can be a cause of constipation.
To release constipation, pregnant woman should include high fiber food in her diet, like cereals, whole grains, fruits, vegetables. Drinking plenty of water and exercising regularly will also help to release constipation during pregnancy.
Pregnant women are at higher risk of developing anemia because during pregnancy, body produces more blood to supply nutrients to the growing fetus. There are different types of anemia, but the most common anemia during pregnancy are iron deficiency anemia, folate deficiency anemia, and vitamin B12 deficiency anemia. Anemia during pregnancy can easily be tackled by including iron-rich foods in the diet.
Pregnant women should include red meat, poultry, eggs, dark green leafy vegetables, nuts and seeds, beans and lentils in her diet.
Iron supplements also recommended in addition of consuming these iron-rich foods.
Foods high in vitamin C can help body to absorb more iron, so it is important to include vitamin C rich food in the diet, like oranges, strawberries, tomatoes, kiwi, and bell peppers. Pica is an eating disorder that involves an irresistible desire to ingest or lick substances that are not edible, like soil, sand, chalk, ice, and plaster.
This problem occurs during the first and second trimester of pregnancy, and this disorder discontinues after giving birth. The solution for this problem is to educate the woman about the dangers and the need of discontinuing these practices. Heartburn is very common problem during pregnancy. It can be caused by hormonal changes or pressure on the stomach. It's easy to tackle heartburn problem by making changes in diet and lifestyle.
Consume bland food, avoid oily and spicy food, take antacid if prescribed by doctor, plan small and frequent meals. Urinary urgency. To control this problem, pregnant women should avoid consuming tea, coffee and spicy food.
Muscle cramping can be a normal part of pregnancy. To avoid muscle cramping, calcium intake should be increased and phosphorus intake should be reduced.
This is the table for daily nutritional requirement of pregnant woman above 18 years with ideal body weight. The nutritional requirements of non-pregnant woman are compared with the nutritional requirement of pregnant woman, and we can see the difference clearly. Vitamin A requirement per day is increased by 70 microgram per day. Vitamin D requirement is also increased during pregnancy by 10 microgram per day. Folate requirement is increased by 200 microgram per day. Niacin requirement for pregnant woman is 18 milligram per day. Riboflavin requirement is 1.4 milligram per day. Thiamine requirement is also same like riboflavin, 1.4 milligram per day. Vitamin B6 requirement is 1.9 milligram per day. Vitamin B12, 2.6 microgram per day. Vitamin C requirement, 85 milligram per day. Calcium requirement, 1000 milligram per day. Here we can see iron requirement of pregnant woman is 27 milligram per day, which is much more than the non-pregnant woman's iron requirement. Phosphorus requirement is 700 milligram per day. Selenium requirement also increased, it's 60 microgram per day. And zinc requirement is also increased, which is 11 microgram per day. Protein requirement for pregnant woman is 71 gram per day, and fiber requirement is also increased, which is 28 grams per day. Pregnant woman should consume 350 more calories than her daily calorie requirements. Weight gain during pregnancy is very important. Let's see how it should be. Weight gain during pregnancy is depend upon the woman's nutritional status prior to becoming pregnant. If the woman is underweight at the time of pregnancy, she should gain 12.5 to 18 kg of weight during pregnancy. The rate of weight gain in the second and third trimester should be 0.58 kg per week. If a woman is normal body weight with BMI 18.5 to 24.9, she should increase 11 to 16 kg of her body weight, and the rate of weight gain during second and third trimester should be 0.35 to 0.50 kg per week. If a woman is overweight at the time of pregnancy, she should gain total 7 to 11.5 kg weight, and the rate of weight gain in the second and third trimester should be 0.23 to 0.33 kg per week. If a woman is obese at the time of pregnancy, she should gain 5 to 9 kg of weight during her pregnancy, and the rate of weight gain in the second and third trimester should be 0.17 to 0.27 kilograms per week.
Nutrition is important component of fetal development. Nutritional counseling is necessary for all women during pregnancy. Nutritional status of woman is not only affects her health but also the health of her growing baby. Individual nutrition counseling is important because socioeconomic status of women, women's access to food, body mass index, cultural food choices needs to be considered. Again, nutritional counseling for complicated pregnancy is different. Pregnant woman must understand that her lifestyle practices affecting her baby's health. It's highly recommended to adopt healthy lifestyle practices during pregnancy like moderate exercise and eating healthy diet. Healthy pregnant woman will ensure her baby the best start at life. Thanks for watching. If you found this video useful, hit the like button, leave your comment. Don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get latest updates from Nutralife. See you next week. Bye.